dictation start now. A reading of the impugn order shows that the learned single judge did not find any jurisdictional error in the award of the labor court. He also did not find that the award was vitiated by any error of law apparent on the face of the record, or that there was violation of rules of natural justice. As a matter of fact, the learned single judge rejected the argument of the corporation that termination of the appellant service falls within the ambit of Section 2 of the Act, and expressed agreement with the labor court that the action taken by the managing director of corporation was contrary to Section 25G of the Act, which embodies the rule of last come first go. Notwithstanding this, the learned single judge substituted the award of reinstatement of the appellant with compensation of ₹37,582 by assuming that appellant was initially appointed without complying with the equality clause in Shrin in Article 14 and 16 of the Constitution of India, and the relevant regulations. While doing so, the learned single judge failed to notice that in the reply filed on behalf of the corporation before the labor court, the appellant's claim for instatement with back wages was not resisted on the ground that his initial appointment was illegal or unconstitutional, and that neither any evidence was produced nor any arguments was advanced in that regard. Therefore, the labor court did not get any opportunity to consider the issue whether reinstatement should be denied to the appellant by applying the new jurisprudence developed by the superior courts in recent years, that the court should not pass an award which may result in perpetuation of illegality. This being this position, the learned single judge was not at all justified in entertaining the new plea raised on behalf of the corporation. For the first time during the course of arguments and deprive the appellant have of what may be the only source of his own sustenance and that of his family. Another serious error committed by the learned single judge is that he decided the writ petition by erroneously assuming that the appellant was a daily wage employee. This is ex facie contrary to the averments contained in the statement of claim filed by the workman that he was appointed in the scale of ₹350 to ₹525, and the order dated 3 October 1986 and 25th February 1987, issued by the concerned executive engineer appointing the appellant as work munshi in the pay scale of ₹355 to ₹525, and then in the scale of ₹400 and ₹600. This was not even the case of the corporation that the appellant was employed on daily wages. It seems that attention of the learned single judge was not drawn to the relevant records, else he would not have passed the impugn order on a wholly unfounded assumption that the appellant was a daily wager. It is true that in the writ petition filed by it, the corporation did plead that the dispute raised by the appellant was not an industrial dispute because he had not worked continuously for a period of 240 days.